Yeah. Private Osborne. That one. How old are you?
18.
Very good.
You're about to be inducted into the British Army. The Army is a fighting service. If you're not prepared to do either of these things, that is fight or serve, please leave now. You're required to follow orders without question or hesitation. If you can feel you're not able to do these things or you're not prepared to do these things, please leave now. This will be a challenging experience. The going will be rough. Conditions in the trench are hard. You may be ordered to do things you find to be unpleasant. If you're not prepared to do this, or you feel you cannot do this, you are not prepared for this experience. Please leave now. I take that as assent. If you kindly move down to the next officer, he will get you to the oath.
I will need you to say your name after I say I begin A, and then I will end, so help me God, and you will need to say so help me God. I do make oath that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to His Majesty King George V, his heirs and successors. And as in duty bound, I will honestly and faithfully defend His Majesty in person, crown and dignity against all enemies. And will observe and obey all orders of His Majesty, generals and the officers set over me. So help me God.
The Army is a fighting service.
Welcome. You are now a member of the British Army. Best of British luck. Zoom three, it lifts my heart.
Okay, I can take it. I'm angry. This way, can we do this, please?
Your best, new best friend.
Good.
Go on, do the chop. My platoon.
We've got to go in.
There's two more.
Very good, Colonel. Platoon 4, we'd like you to make your way to Private... No, Corporal, Colonel. Sorry, Corporal. And collect your rifle, and then make your way to the top of the hill to meet the Sergeant Major. Thank you very much.
Good luck, boys.
Cheers.
Very good, Platoon 5.
My squadron
3. Okay, you'll be alright, you'll catch them up at the parade ground.
Corporal Colonel, very good. Platoon 5, could you make your way to Corporal Colonel, collect a rifle, head to the top of the hill and meet the Sergeant Major at the top. Thank you very much. Keep an eye, not too much smiling, sir.
Hey, thanks.
Black boys.
Okay, Davey! Platoon 6, please make your way to Corporal Colonel. Collect your rifles, make your way to the top of the hill where the Sergeant Major will be.
Cornish boys here, lift my arm.
One moment, take my word, young man.
Got any more rifles?
Very good. go for 2-8. Please make your way to Corporal Kerner. Get your dog tag, anybody got one of those. Get a gun and head up to the hill to see the Sergeant Major. Are they in there?
There. Thank you. Lads.
Yep.
Is the office open, do you know?
Don't know actually.
Well, that's the ones that have been repaired are in the office.
Okay. Having repaired, is there?
There'll be no waving tonight.
Can you please check your dog tags?
Isn't
it? Check who you are.
Captain Corporal Kerner. Sorry, Corporal. Head up the hill to Sergeant Major at the top.
That's all right.
Bigger privates. Looking smart.
Quite young people, guns.
At last, we're assembled. Let me introduce myself. I am Major Oates, 134th Cornwall Heavy Brigade, Royal Garrison Artillery.
And I'm Sergeant Major Hocking, 10th Duke of Cornwall's Light Infantry.
So, good of you all to turn up. Coming, as many of you do, from a strong mining tradition, you'll have more to offer than most. This war is depending on pick and shovel work. Men like you, who can tunnel and dig. Dig trenches to protect our own forces, and tunnels to undermine the enemy positions. Now, from time to time, many of you may be troubled by doubt, but is it not the case that in time of war, every patriot must declare for his country, right or wrong? Can we stand by? Can we stand by when the Boche over in France and in Belgium and in Flanders, when they are gouging out the eyes of civilians? When they're crucifying our captured soldiers, when they're cutting off the hands of teenage boys, when they're bayoneting babies, can we stand by when we can have them on the run within 6 weeks? We can only do this, though, with your help. We can have them out of France, out of Flanders, out of Belgium and across the Rhine and back into their own territory. But we can only do it with your help. We can give them a taste of their own medicine, but only with your help. No war was ever won by the other fellow. We must do it together, all of us, thousands of us, hundreds of thousands of us, or it will not be done at all.
Sir, one of my platoon is worried, being a Methodist. What about the sixth commandment, thou shalt not kill?
I'm a religious man too. And God tells us to stand up for what's right. It is not a sin to carry a rifle. It doesn't make us murderers. We are human. We do it purely because it's our duty.
Especially in this war, where our cause is right and God is on our side.
Sir, what are our chances of making it home, sir?
I truly believe that we will all get through this in one piece. But if the unexpected were to happen, we must rest content in the knowledge that we have done our duty. No chap can do more than that. We have a choice. We can fight proud or we can skulk at home and live in shame. Very good. I'm going to read you a report, a letter written directly to you boys from our General Field Marshal Haig. He writes, I am well aware that you Cornish start work in the mines at the age of 12. That you go underground at the age of 15. Your toil, your labour, and your remarkable work rate are not in question. Nor is the fact that you are constantly surrounded by dangers that would appall the stoutest heart. But nothing, nothing can prepare you for the front line, gentlemen. So, on that uplifting note, We are now going to march to the front line, where no doubt we will come under fire. So if any of you have the slightest doubt about enlisting, or believe that you cannot follow orders, now is the time to leave. Well, soldiers, are you ready to follow orders? Stand up straight, soldier. Face front, good. Are you ready to follow orders?
Yes, sir.
And you, soldier?
Yes, sir.
And you, soldier?
Yeah.
Very good. What about you, soldier?
Yes, sir.
And what is your duty, soldier?
To serve king and country, sir.
Very good. To serve king and country and to follow orders from your platoon commanders, your sergeant major, and your officers at all costs. Very good. All right, sergeant major. I think we're ready. We can move them out.
Company, attention! Ranks of three, fall in!
And front row, halt!
One moment, Sergeant Major.
Pick it up, soldier.
Good, Madden. Nearly there, men! Company!
If you'd like to inform the men.
Sergeant! We're now approaching the front line. Shortly, we're going to march, or we're going to walk up to the communication trench and into the trench, which is the front line. Follow the path that's been marked by the Cornish pioneers. Stay between the white gates. Outside of here, there are shell holes that are thrown full of mud. If you fall in, you will drown. There's also unexploded ordnance. That's shells and bombs to you lot. Keep moving steadily.
unless you're told to stop. Keep moving. Keep your head down and keep quiet. This is one of the most dangerous times for the regiments moving to and from the line. Apart from no man's land, that is.
Keep moving.
Keep moving. Keep quiet. If the worst should happen and all hell breaks loose, do not run. The ground has been cleared of bombs, but not stones. If you trip over and sprain your ankle, you will be out of the fight. And what's more, you will be standing still. Therefore, you will be a sitting duck for the Germans. Keep moving steadily. Sir.
And to reiterate, stay between the white lines marked out by the Cornish pioneers. You see them in front of you.
They are important. Numerous explosive devices that we will no doubt encounter. Therefore, it is absolutely essential that once in the trench, you keep your head below the parapet. Once in there, report to your platoon commander and make yourself at home. Madam,
sure.
You have to take your platoon up first.
Right, number 9 platoon with me. Are you ready? Remember what I said. Keep moving. Keep your heads down.
Paul!
Fallen, boys, come on!
Heads down,
heads down! Keep it moving! Get off the walkway! Get off the walkway!
Head down!
I'm Corporal Courtney. I'm Willie Courtney. I look after you. Stick with me.
Very good.
Very good.
All present and correct, Sergeant Major.
Yes, looking very good.
All right. You get them to sound off for me.
Sound off, platoons.
Platoon number one, sir. Platoon number two, Sarge.
Platoon three, Sarge.
Platoon four, Sarge.
Five, sir.
Six.
Seven.
Platoon eight, Sarge.
Number nine, platoon.
Very good.
Very good.
Very good. Welcome to the front line. Welcome to the Western Front. Now, that didn't quite go as we expected. You can see how easy it is for the Hun to pick us off if they want to, when they can tell where we are. Very good. But we're here. Welcome to the front line. So, you are expected to stay here. You are not allowed to leave. No one may leave this trench now. Unless it be under the strict orders of an officer. Should any part of this trench fall into enemy hands, remember, no retreat is allowed. Is that clear to you, soldiers?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Very good. In a short while, we shall begin the Somme offensive. Now, either side of you, 100,000 infantry are lined up, ready. In front of us, directly in front of us here, is the village of La Boiselle. To the north, we have finished now digging Wysap Mine. Here, we are helping to dig Loch Nagar Mine. Our tunnelers are busy increasing mining activity at the moment in the hope that any attack on the Somme will be taken by the Boche as merely a diversionary tactic. You will all be expected to help with this mining activity before we go over. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Very good. How are you doing, soldier? You all right? You're fine. Good. You're very smart. All right. Carry on, Sergeant Major. I'll leave them in your capable hands.
Very good, Major.
All right, corporals. Listen up. Fatigue duty. Trimble.
I need two men to the tunnel.
Trothin, where are you?
Sarge!
I need two men to the firing step. Remember to relieve them as soon as the other two take over the position.
Sarge. Anguin!
Sarge!
Get your men on rest. Get to know your boys.
Veal!
Sarge!
Prepare weapons for inspection. I will be around shortly to check them.
Yes, Sarge.
Courtney!
Sarge!
Cup of tea and rations if the men are hungry.
Veal!
Sarge!
Private, if you go to the dugout, you'll be able to get some nice cup of tea. Well, cup of tea, not necessarily a nice one. Right, let's just check with Graham and we should have. Channels?
Yes, sir.
It's quite cool. It's quite sir. Williams?
Clean. It's a lovely weapon.
Excellent. Simmons?
Use this. Put it on the wall, on the floor. Okay? And if you hear anything, tell your mate. And you'll go and get some. If your mate hears something to you.
Yeah.
She can hear something or anything. There's a red wire down there.
Yeah.
Can you go get it and ravel it up to me, but wait till she tells you, yeah?
Dusk till dawn. Protection from an enemy attack will be provided by barbed wire, listening, and observation posts. The clue is in the name, Corporal. Listening for sounds of enemy activity. Corporal Veal, would you care to enlighten?
Sir, during the night, recce will be dispatched at intervals to ascertain whether there is any movement on the part of the Hun. Consequently, there will be no firing at night, except by order of the company commander. Whilst in the trenches, full fighting equipment will be worn at all times, and magazines must be fully loaded.
Even my magazine, sir. Why miss times, anyone?
This is not a social gathering, men!
Sir!
We'll have less chit-chat when the Major is in the trench! Davey, please enlighten!
What the Sergeant Major means is that your weapons must always be fully loaded. You must not uncharge your magazine till you go off the line. And always keep rifles within immediate reach.
Carry on, men, as you will.
Right. What are you doing with your weapon there, Friday?
The important
thing. Novice. Always keep your weapons upright, otherwise you're gonna fire someone's head off. Right? We don't want the Fritz are gonna do enough damage. We don't want to do it ourselves, right? You're my platoon.
And good country, sir.
Good drink. Ex, is that you?
Yes, sir.
Well done. John Taylor? Are you John? The John Taylor? Marazine boy? I know you. I've heard about you. Hey, boys! We've got a war hero in our midst. This here John Taylor. You've got a medal boy, haven't you?
Yes, sir, but I don't really like talking about
it. Hey, come on. You're amongst friends now. Johnny. Come on, tell us all about it. What did you do? Have you been over the top?
You're mine and Grenfell. We're a platoon. We're lifting together, okay? We tell each other everything. Where are you from? Actually, that's near the van mine, isn't it? Yeah. Work at the van.
My dear boy, thank you for your news. Have you heard from James?
Yeah. Everyone needs to come straight.
It's just the same. Lovely breeze today. Makes the world seem like a place somehow.
I'll see if we've got any get leaves.
Yes,
yeah,
and
Joss?
Yes, sir.
Just along. You too. Do you know each other?
Want you, with me. Coming
up. Most people that just know each other. No.
Courtney, get these weapons clean up. We'll be inspecting them shortly.
Phil, get your boys a cup of tea.
Two boys to relieve you.
Right, private.
Two boys to relieve
Colonel!
You.
Colonel!
Yes,
I need two boys on sentry duty. Remember
four,
to relieve
five,
the
five, six, okay. Seven, eight, nine cups of tea.
You two.
Keep your heads down.
Do you want to help in private?
Use the periscopes. I want you to kind of observe the enemy. See any movements.
We're here for the next 10 days.
Stand inside the trench. There's someone to see.
And we can have a bath and change of clothes. Not that bad, is it? Got to keep the spirits up. What's your name? What's your name? Where
are we getting from?
Come on,
there you go.
Very good, Janet. Very good.
Do you want to come and sit on this step, private?
Private? Are you eating your rations?
Go on there. It's best to keep off the mud.
Kevin.
You've got to keep seeing as much as possible. Keep the duck boarding clear.
Thanks, Corporal.
You private.
You better get used to it.
Oh, tucking in already, I see. How are these weapons looking down there, man?
Good for nerves.
Yeah, you can get me through my ration pack.
Terrible.
Oh dear. Sorry, Private.
Hey, what's happened here? This is village. Someone in a fancy all their tea today?
Yeah.
Alan, keep these knees under cover, don't look bad now, do we?
Oh.
Harry. Bet you all know Harry Gould. Yeah, well, he's doing all right for himself now. He's in the Navy.
My name's Thomas Nicholas Field.
Last I heard, he was okay, but. Do you miss one thing about being at home? There's one thing that you think back and you Jen Boss, we're just talking about if there was one thing you missed about being at home.
Going down the start from the pint, I reckon. And my missus has passes. She makes passes out of mine. Best passes you can have. Got the mail, lad?
Yes.
See you later, boys.
I've got my eye on you, Gil.
Cheers, Jen Boss.
I know, sir.
Oi! It's bad luck to light the same cigarette off a match! Three cigarettes, in fact!
I'm not superstitious, sir.
Word to the wise, Corporal. How long do you think it takes to light three cigarettes?
Dunno. About 5 seconds?
Davy, please enlighten.
How long do you think it takes a German sniper to spot a light in the dark, take aim and fire?
About 5 seconds.
Blimey, they'll be telling us these are bad for our health next.
Thanks
anyway, baby.
It's
all right.
Yeah.
Enjoy your tea?
Yeah, lovely. Thanks.
Very sweet.
Maybe after
that. You over that trench, that was.
No, I just don't. I couldn't.
Hey guys, listen,
didn't fancy it.
I'm not a tea drinker anyway.
Probably a bit light in it. Because the wash isn't very hot. But it's nice to be off the line a couple of weeks. Alright, Sergeant, so for
pressure? Nothing.
How did you get on?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Sergeant, yes. David's a long wait.
A long wait? Right, that's very good. He's a funny one, isn't he? Life. Well, the lights are like
this. Officer
Brazen!
Straighten your backs, boys. Good. All right. Rest easy, men. Rest easy. Good, you're looking very smart. Well done. Got some news now. I have news from General Headquarters. And men, it's the news we've been waiting for. We've been designated to go over at 0730 hours. 0730 hours. About 20 minutes. All right. This is the finest thing, men, that you will ever do in your lives. Carry on. Well done. How do you feel, all right? Yeah? Yeah?
Confident.
You're feeling confident?
Yeah.
That's what we like to hear. Very good. Let's get them. Absolutely. Well done. You soldier? Sir, yes, sir. Nice and loud.
Yes, sir.
Good. Well done. All right.
You there, soldier. What's your name?
Hodge, sir.
Hodge, very good. Take three men over the top into no man's land. We need a prisoner.
Yes, sir.
Very good, Hodge.
Taylor?
Barnes?
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 Finish Mark's. And
row.
Two on each ladder. Here in those ones.
Good luck, Hodge.
Best of luck, boys.
Down, follow your own advice.
Let's sort out the kitty.
Oh. Hand their coins over. There's no use to you out there.
Ones you make it back.
Can't.
Never know, you might make a tidy profit.
I'll hold your sweets if you want.
Come, call.
Thanks, Anne Green.
Private, you there.
If I don't come back, can you write a letter to Nancy Hoskins, Camp 7?
Best of luck, boys! Good luck, Barnes.
Look, Johnny.
I'll be with you.
Look, Barnes.
As you were, man.
Boys. The okay, let's leave some of these boys with their duties. They've been on this for a long, long time.
Thank you.
Hey,
we're
going to need
them. Courtney, where is it?
Courtney.
I need 2 minutes. Safely, you will be able to find it, and perhaps you'll change your mind about sending it. Very good, corporals. Carry on.
Oates, I need you over here.
Find a piece of paper.
Oates, you're going over the top to look for survivors. Hodge might not be the only one.
Very good.
Good luck, boys.
See you not later.
Keep your heads down. Come on, guys. See you later. Bring us back our boys.
Looking for survivors. Right, everyone, carry on with your letters as you want.
I saw this German guy stuck in no man's land. I couldn't see his head sticking out. I thought that was me. I'd like a helping hand. So when it got dark, I crawled out to him.
You never.
I did. I took pity on him, didn't I? So when I got out there, I put a rope around his waist and crawled all the way back. Where I got me pals to help me pull. We pulled and pulled, we did. Couldn't shift him. So I shouted out over to him, "Hey, Fritz, we can't seem to move you." Which he replied, "Will it help if I took my feet out of the stirrups?" Stirrups!
I've got one. If bread is the staff of life,
What is the life of the star?
One long loaf!
Right.
Out! We are about to die, salute you.
Good. Rest easy. Rest easy, man. All right. 0 hour minus 5 now. How are you feeling? Confident?
Yes, sir.
Just to recap.
Keep that head down, soldier.
Yeah, good, sergeant. Keep my head down, too. So, just to recap. The attacking force's objective is to reach the enemy's front line and clear it. All right, we're going to blow Lochnanger mine. At 0728 hours, and that at 0730, we go over. All right, so the enemy has had a solid week of shelling. They won't know whether they're coming or going. They won't know their ass from their elbow. This is going to be a piece of cake. You should feel confident. All right, so platoon number one over. Do you know who you are?
That's Trimba, Truffin, and Gwyn.
Okay, these three will go over first. They will reach and attack the front line and hold the position. Platoon, the second platoon, over.
Veal, Courtney, Veal.
Very good. You will go over after the first and you will act as moppers up. You'll clear the captured ground of any stray Hun and close down any machine guns that haven't been found. All right, then platoon three.
Colonel Davy Madden.
Good. You will follow on with weapons, with tools, with ammunition for your compatriots, all right? And then you will also protect against German counterattack. Very good, carry on.
Remember you have a choice of weapon, men. Veal, would you like to enlighten?
Sir, you can use your rifle or your bayonet.
Well, my favorite, the trenching tool. See, it's a spade, much more versatile. You can strike a blow with lots more force behind it.
You can either hit him under the chin like that or bring it down between his neck and his shoulder, splitting him right down to the chest.
When you put a bayonet in, it can stick. And you're going to have to give the other man a hefty kick in the guts to get it out. That wastes valuable time.
Very good, men. Let's rally to the ladders.
Good.
We need more ammunition. Right. We'll be getting a bombardment. After the bombardment finishes, we're going over.
Everybody off the walkway! Get as tight to the ladder as you can, men! Come on!
Permission for prayer, sir.
Prayer granted, Veal. Take it away.
Come on, get a grip, man.
Once, in the murmur of leaves, I could hear thee. Now, in the thunder of war, I am near thee.
Fountain of mercy, I pray thee protect me. Father, oh bless me, I pray thee protect me.
Into thine hands, my life I surrender. Thou hast bestowed it. Now take it, defender.
Living or dying, I pray thee protect me. I praise thee, Lord. I pray, protect me.
When all the thunders of war begin roaring, when from our veins the red blood is pouring.
With hope in my heart, my life I trust to thee. Whatever today must be, my life I trust to thee.
All right, Ben. It's now 0 hour minus 2.
Major, call from headquarters. You need it.
Talk
to
me, let's go! All right,
we'll
call Corporal. All right, remember, wait for the ammunition.
Take my ammunition.
We need more ammunition.
Take my ammunition. Take my ammunition.
the Germans. Are they singing?
Singing songs, yeah.
It's Christmas.
It's Christmas.
It's Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Carl.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, well done, boys. Well done.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, boys.
Merry Christmas.
Sarge. 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 Merry Christmas, Sarge. Merry Christmas,
well, let's give
them
one back then, shall we?
Yeah, let's give them the Eastern, yeah?
The Eastern!
Back in the store on Christmas Eve!
Oh, oh, yes.
Go on, Phil!
You know it, boys!
Lo, the Eastern sages rise at a signal in the skies. Tis the Star of Bethlehem, brighter than the brightest gem. Tis the Star of Bethlehem. Joyful let us quickly rise, still the signal in the skies. Tis the Star of Bethlehem, brighter than the brightest gem. Tis the Star of Bethlehem.
You get that, old friends?
How are you doing today, Danny? Merry Christmas! I hear you've decided to pack up and go home.
No, John! We're enjoying ourselves too much!
Would you like some tobacco?
Oh, yeah! Huh? Dankeschön! Oh, look out!
They're there!
They want biscuits?
Biscuits, they want biscuits! Has anyone got any biscuits?
No?
No one's got any in their rations?
Sorry, Fritz, we're out of biscuits!
Never mind! God bless you, darling!
God bless you! I've never been there!
I work at the Flower and Hammer Hotel on Henry Road!
You what? Birmingham!
I was a waiter! I come back to Germany to fight the war! Hopefully, it will soon be over and I can go back to Birmingham!
Yeah, I hope so too!
Would you like to come and meet us in No Man's Land?
They've got their weapons.
So we can take ours.
How many of them are there?
Sure.
About 15? No tricks!
Nine!
Your mother's a team too!
Lads, what do you think?
Privates,
make your way. In private, come on. Let's face them. Right up, move right up, privates, right up.
Come on, let's get I'm Walter Kossler. I was an architect before I was conscripted. You?
Wilfred Mitchell. And I come from St. Just.
St. Just. Pleased to meet you.
Hey, Mitchell. Come to the German.
Another one.
I am Stefan Westman. I was a medical student. I will not forget one of your British soldiers who helped collect my wounded during the cruise. Dankeschön. And you, your name?
I am Peter Simmons. I'm from St. Just.
Excited, Simmons?
Simmons.
Simmons, yes.
You calm down there, Simmons.
Greetings.
Cornish boys!
Yay! Duke of Cornwall Infantry! Go DCLI, lads!
Yes, it's a battalion!
Can
Canadian Wall Tunnelling Company?
Australian Imperial Force!
Right. Prince of Wales Volunteers, South Lancashire Regiment.
Damagers,
8th
Battalion.
Hey, boys! It takes 5 British regiments to fight just one!
Come on, dummy, it's Christmas. What was it like in your trench?
What was the battle like in your trench?
It was wonderful. We had a goat and fresh milk every day.
Yeah. Be serious, August. For 7 nights and 7 days, you British have shelled us. Our dugouts crumbled and fell on us.
We had to dig our comrades and ourselves out. Sometimes we found them suffocated, sometimes smashed to bits.
The soldiers and their bunkers became hysterical.
We wanted to leave, but fights developed to keep us from going.
Even the Reds became hysterical. They came to hide in our bunkers from the shells and artillery fire.
For 7 nights and 7 days, we've had nothing to drink and nothing to eat. Just shells raining down on us all the time, shells bursting down on us.
And then your British came over the top.
The very moment we felt your machine guns move to the reserve trenches, our machine gunners came out of their bunkers.
Red and eyes, sunken eyes, dirty, full of the blood of our poor comrades.
But they laid down a terrific fire! The summer.
Yeah. One can't possibly feel happy in a place where all nature has been devastated.
Yeah.
We are civilized men, living in old dirty trenches.
Fighting for water? I'm not going to live till I'm 30. Hey, Tommy. How much do they pay you?
Where the hell is my regiment?
Eyes front, men! I said eyes front! Hello! I'm here! Colonel! I'm over here! Who the bloody hell are you talking to, corporals?
Prince, sir!
You seem very pally! You forget that the Huns are barbarians!
Surely not, sir. Even Beethoven and Mozart...
You're trying to be clever, corporal! You forget that Fritz will slice your throat with his bayonet unless you do it to him first!
What the hell is going on, Sergeant Major? Friendly intercourse with the enemy and the exchange of gifts, however tempting and amusing it might be, is absolutely forbidden! You understand that?
Yes, very good, Major.
Good. Must see that it leads to a weakening of the fighting spirit. This sort of chumminess must be discouraged at all costs. And to that end, this regiment now has orders to be taken off the front line. Your glory days are over, men. Very good. You will be replaced by the Scots Guards. All right, Sergeant Major, take them out.
Very good, boys. It's your lucky day. Ranks of 3.
All right, boys. Very good. Line up. We're moving out of here.
Line up behind this corporal here. Line up behind here.
Very good.
Ranks of 3. Good.
Left. 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 Right. Left. 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 Right. Left. 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 Right. Left.
Tommy,
we're
talking to you, sir.
Hey.
Blood pencils and
stone. No! Carry on, men! Eyes front! Quick march!
Right, it's eyes front.
Left! 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 Right! Left!
Left!
Fit after what you've been through. Very good. Very good. Well done, men. That's right, catch up. We must bring the football.
Two more people over here in front.
I'd like to read you the report from General Headquarters after our first day. There was hardly a German within miles because the front line had been flattened by the artillery. He writes, it all went like clockwork.
none of our battalion made it to the German lines, sir. We couldn't. It was impossible.
We have fought a glorious battle.
But, sir, haven't you heard the estimated British casualties from the first day of the battle, sir?
This magnificent advance could not have been made without some loss of life.
There were 20,000 killed during the day and a further 40,000 wounded, sir.
However, the men are in excellent spirits. In fact, they talk proudly about the operation, about how they were so well informed and instructed about what they were to achieve.
The night before, each dugout was given a gallon bottle of rum. So every man was drunk, blind drunk. I remember thinking at the time, this looks like a sacrifice.
The preparations were meticulous. Barbed wire was never so well cut.
The German trenches were 30 feet deep. They were safe as a bank. A rabbit couldn't have got through their barbed wire.
Nevertheless, the men are in excellent spirits. The battle was a success.
I was one
successful
of the lucky
ones for us.
When I crept back into the trench at the end of the day, there were a couple of officers there. They were surprised to see me. No one else.
Yeah, I got back, went down to a bunker, slept for 14 hours. There was no one there. The Germans could have walked through.
We were informed that the Germans are now surrendering freely.
Come on, sir. You know that's not true.
I will now read out a list of names, the roll call. When you hear your name read out, I'd like you to come forward to the Sergeant Major. He will inform you of your fate. If you survived, I'd like you to come and stand near the corporal near me. Thank you. John Barnes. Well done, Private.
Sergeant. Over the hill, John.
It's been a pleasure, Sergeant.
William Ewart Courtney.
Survived, Will.
Jack Lego.
Jack. Survived, Jack.
Matthew Eddie Matthews.
Matthew Eddie Matthews.
Here he comes.
Here he is in the back.
Well done, soldier.
Survived, Matthew.
William John George.
Survived, Will.
Leonard Sammons.
Leonard Sammons. Leonard Sammons.
Well done, Leonard.
Survived, Leonard.
Solomon Tremba.
Solomon. Over the hill, Solomon.
Henry Murley.
Henry Murley.
Henry Murley.
Check your tag if you're unsure. Oh, Henry. Survived, Henry.
Well done, Henry. Thomas Murley.
Thomas Murley. Here comes Tom.
Step forward, lads. Don't be shy.
All right, Tom.
Over the hill, Tom.
Ralph Ellis.
Here comes Ralph now.
All right, Ralph.
Survived, Ralph.
Gregory Trudgeon.
Over the hill, Gregory.
Sorry, Gregory. William Perry Stevens.
Over the hill, Will.
William Cecil Osborne.
Over the hill, Will.
And Jack Thomas. All right, Jack.
Survive, Jack.
James Edwin Davy.
Hill, Jim.
Harold Morris.
Survived, Harold.
Frank Frank Pender Thomas.
Over the hill, Frank.
John Lego.
Over the hill, John.
John Permewin Channels. John Channels, here comes John.
Over the hill, John.
Nicholas M. Williams.
Over the hill, sir.
Survive, Nick.
Justice Jesse Angwin. Angwin, you here?
Survive, Justice.
William Walker Harry. William Harry. Here we go.
Survive, Will.
William John Harvey.
Over the hill, Will.
James Hawking.
Over the hill, Jim.
Edward Laurie.
Over the hill, Ed.
Nicholas Murley.
Nick
Hello, Nicholas.
Survive, Nick.
William Nankervis.
Two good. For William Nankervis.
Is that Thomas Nankervis and William Nankervis?
Sorry.
No, Thomas has come
are you
as
William?
Well.
Yes. Over the hill, Will.
And this is Thomas.
Thomas.
Well done.
You survived.
Humphrey Arthur Rowe. James Rowe.
Over the hill, James.
Willie Stone.
Over the hill, Willie.
Frederick Trewartha Roberts.
Over the hill, Fred.
Charles Olds.
Over the hill, Charlie.
John Taylor.
Survived.
William Casely.
Survived, Will.
Guildford Rizay.
Over the hill, Gil.
Wilfred Mitchell.
Over the hill, Wilfred.
William Madern Eddy.
Over the hill, Will.
James Trothen.
Over the hill, Jim.
Thomas Henry Simmons.
Over the hill, Tom.
Peter James Simmons.
Over the hill, Pete.
Harry Williams.
Harry. Over the hill, Harry.
James Tresize. Thomas Madden.
Survive, Tom.
Well done, Thomas. William Tonkin.
Survive, Will.
Hugh Oates.
Survive, Hugh.
Nicholas Oates Hosking.
Over the hill, Nick.
Samuel Bone.
Over the hill, Sammy.
Harold. Well done. Harold Trevorrow.
Over the hill.
Andrew Angwin Hall.
Survived.
Richard Kerno.
Over the hill, Rich.
William Henry Waters.
Over the hill, Will.
John Wallace.
Over the hill, John.
William George Trewern.
Over the hill, Will.
Jack Kevern.
Survive, Jack.
Thanks.
James Henry Oates.
Survive, Jim.
Thomas Nicholas Veal.
Survived.
It's a pleasure, sir.
William Williams.
Survived.
William Edwards Tresize.
William Tresize.
Good man.
Survived.
Howell Garfield Madden.
Survived, Sergeant.
Over the hill, Madden.
Humphrey Trembath.
Over the hill, Humphrey.
God bless you, sir.
James Thomas.
Over the hill, Jim.
Samuel Chuala Davy.
Survived.
Yes. William Old Thomas.
Over the hill.
William Sidney Harvey. William Harvey. William Prowse.
Over the hill, Will.
John Tregear Angwin.
Sarge.
Over the hill, John.
William Bennett.
Survived.
Samuel Veal.
Survived.
Sir. Thank you, sir.
Very good, Bill.
Royston Squire Griffiths.
Royston. Over the hill, Royston.
Hamlet James.
Survived, Hamlet.
Selby Gelbart.
Selby.
Edward Casey Cotter.
Survived.
Charles Freestone.
Survived.
Henry Harvey.
Survived, Henry.
Thank you, Pascoe Ellis Davy.
Over the hill.
Richard Grenfell.
See you, Jack.
Over the hill, Rich.
What's your name, soldier?
William J. Harvey.
William Harvey.
William Harvey.
Well done, come forward.
Hang on, Harvey, we may have missed you. William Harvey, William Harvey, William Harvey. William John Harvey. Over the hill, Will.
Sorry, William. George Stevens Hodge.
Survived, Hodge.
Well done. Sergeant Hawking.
Over the hill, sir.
Right so.
Sir, may I just ask where this hill is?
It was in Belgium, Sergeant.
Belgium.
In Flanders fields, the poppies grow. Between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place.
And in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly, scarce amid the guns below.
We are the dead.
Short days ago, we lived.
Felt dawn.
Saw sunset glow.
Loved and were loved.
And now we lie in Flanders fields.
Take up our quarrel with the foe.
To you, from failing hands, we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high.
If ye break faith with us that die, we shall not sleep.
Though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
Hats off. We'll take a moment to remember the fallen of St. Justin Tendy. Mount your puppies. Stand with your fallen comrade. Well done. And now, three cheers for the men and women of St. Justin Pendeen and the whole of this great land. Then and now, hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.